Anyway, I guess it's important, and so is the level of the river.
Yeah, at least that's much easier to figure out, because it's not going to go much higher than it is right now. We've got some minor flooding along the river, but most of it's not from the rain that fell, but really from the snow melt that was upstream across parts of Pennsylvania and West Virginia. Remember, they had close to 40, 50 inches of snow.
We remember. It all affects us.
Yeah, it all has to roll downstream, so to speak, and it's doing that. The good news is that we're actually flooding now because, you know, it may preclude a bigger flood event in terms of, you know, as we get deeper and deeper into the spring, we start running the risk of seeing heavier rainfall events. So if we get all the snow melt out of the river basin now, then we can set the stage for where we can accept more rainfall. We'll be able to hold or handle much better a larger rain event. So we'll see how that pans out, but that's where we're standing right now. It's 45 at the airport, 47 Lunkin, 46 in Hamilton, 45 at News 5. Temperatures are pretty uniform across the area. Everyone is kind of stuck in the gloom, so to speak. Live radar is quiet. If you have any plans for heading out this evening, you can leave the umbrellas in the car. I don't think you will need them. And today is the worst day of the week. From here, it's all the way up or down, depends on how you look at it, as high pressure will kind of build down from the upper Midwest that will eventually scour out the clouds and the moisture and really set us up for a very nice week, very early spring-like weather heading our way. We got to get through tonight, though, with clouds and kind of damp, chilly, coolish weather conditions. The sun's back tomorrow. How much sun we see Tuesday is questionable, but we'll see plenty of it through the week. And then it looks like by the weekend, another front will move our way with some rain chances, and then it's going to turn much colder. So the Ohio River at Cincinnati coming up just shy of 49 feet. Flood stage is 52 feet. We're expected to go up to 52.7 feet St. Patrick's Day afternoon. So only 7/10 above flood stage. Very, very minor flooding. Some other locations, Markland Dam expected to crest below action stage, so we're pretty good there. Melda Hall Dam going to also crest just below flood stage on St. Patrick's Day. And at Maysville, the latest numbers now have it at about 50.2 feet. So even here, too, in Maysville, it's just barely going to creep its way above flood stage. Temperatures across the region generally are in the 40s. We look to our west. There's no real cold air. It's 48 Chicago, 53 Peoria, 53 in St. Louis. That's the air that we'll be building in here for our day on Tuesday. So other than a few clouds, that's about all we have to contend with. And microcast, well, it's all about the clouds. And I do think tomorrow will at least end the day with some sun. So for tonight, 37, cloudy, damp, and cool. Tomorrow, 54 the afternoon high. And here's your 7-day forecast. Look like we'll climb our way towards 60 by the end of the week with rain in time for the weekend.